All right, I'm going to try really hard not to freak out during this video, but after doing some research into the show and all of that, I realized this could all end really badly. But before we get into it, guys, make sure that you subscribe to the channel, make sure you like the video, and comment below how you think this season is going to go. Do you think they're going to get it right, or could they miss a lot of really crucial things? So if you don't know, the Wheel of Time series is coming out this November, and as of yet, they have not released a trailer yet, which is, like, kind of concerning. But they've already started filming season 2, it's already gotten greenlit for season, so I guess we could trust that everything's going pretty well, but we haven't gotten a trailer yet, and it's like, it's really bothering me a lot. Just the fact that Witcher already has its trailer out, and it doesn't come out till December, like, why have we not seen anything yet from the Wheel of Time? And it's slightly concerning, because they're gonna try to fit 3 books into 1 season. Game of Thrones basically had a book per season, until near the end, they started expanding it a little bit more, because they're running out of source material, but we are having 3 books in 1 season, and it's like, oh man, like, things could go bad if they are not handled well. So it's not, I don't think it's been explicitly, like, confirmed, like, the studio's come out and said this. I believe they are going to be covering the books, New Spring, The Eye of the World, and The Great Hunt. And the reason why I think so is because, according to, like, their casting and stuff like that, there's characters that they cast that is not in, like, the main series. So I think we're going to get New Spring as, like, flashback sort of stuff. I don't think it's going to have entire episodes dedicated to it, but we will probably get some flashbacks from Moraine, and maybe we'll get some stuff at the beginning to give context for what is happening. But I don't think they'll take up, like, entire episodes. Like, the main part of the series, we're going to be focusing on Moraine, and we're going to be focusing on the Emmonsfield 5. It'll probably sort of be like The Witcher, where The Witcher, like, had all of these flashbacks. It had a lot of crazy stuff going on, but they had, like, whole segments that were flashbacks, and I feel like we'll get that to get some context of, like, why Moraine is on the journey that she's on. So let's get into the episodes and what they're called. I'm just going to go down the list. I'm going to start from the first episode and go to the last, and then I'm going to give some, like, final thoughts. But here's the first episode. It's called Leave Taking. So in this episode, I think they're probably going to set up Moraine, set up a lot of the context for the show on what's going on, and then it's going to have, obviously, the Emmonsfield 5 and the kids and stuff like that. We're going to get to know them a little bit. We're going to get to know Moraine, probably a little bit halfway through the episode, or maybe a little bit on. We're going to get the attack from Trollocs, and we're going to have Moraine, like, doing all her things, showing off the magic, and basically getting the kids out of the two rivers to Tarvalen. Episode 2 is called Shadows Waiting. This is probably going to be more at, like, Shadar Logoth, and we're going to see a lot of the stuff that happens there, because some critical things happen. It'll probably be, like, a really cool, like, world building episode, and just figuring out what this world is. The world's sort of getting bigger, and then probably near the end of this episode, everyone's going to be breaking apart, and this is where people starting to go their separate ways. Oh, also, we'll get the dagger obviously introduced here, and all the stuff that happens with Matt. After that, the next episode is called A Place of Safety. So this will probably be the stuff that happens in Camelin, and what happens with, like, Perrin and all the people with, like, the tinkers and stuff like that. After, like, them being chased and all this crazy stuff happening, episode 3 will probably be, like, not like a completely chill episode, because we need to go through a lot of events in the time that we have, but it's probably going to be, like, everyone is able to rest for a second. They're with the tinkers. Obviously, some stuff goes down. They're in Camelin, and we're able to rest for a second, and then we're, like, getting back into things. The episode 4 is called The Dragon Reborn. So I'm thinking this is the end of the Eye of the World at episode 4, so basically, like, the halfway point. So the first half is going to be 4 episodes with book 1, and then the second half is going to be 4 episodes of The Great Hunt, and we have, like, mixed in the New Spring sort of stuff. But yeah, episode 4 is going to be, like, our mid-season finale, kind of how, like, Walking Dead does, and it's going to have this huge climactic moment with them at the Blight. Rand is really going to show he is the Dragon Reborn and show off, like, some of his power, basically, so that'll be really, really cool to see. Alright, guys, I'm back. I'm a little bit differently dressed. I had to take some break from filming. I had a lot of videos I was doing, so we're back again, and the next episode is called Blood Calls Blood. In this episode, I think this is going to be kind of, like, a fall in action, basically, so not as, like, crazy as it's been, especially with the last episode. It should have been them fighting in the Blight. So this is them back in Fal'Dara. It's a falling of action. It's everybody resting for a second, only for a second, because this show's gonna have to be, like, running, dude. Like, it's gonna have to going fast. So we'll probably get the events that happened in Fal'Dara with what happens with Matt's dagger and Plot and Fane, and then obviously the hunt for the Horn of Valir. From there, we're gonna get the girls heading to the White Tower, and then probably the adventures with Loyal, Perrin, Matt, Rand, and Hurin, and the stuff with the portal stones and all that. I wonder if we're going to go all the way to the point to where Rand gets separated from all of them and then has to fight Balzamon and then gets the Perrin mark on his palm. And then I feel like at the end of this episode, it's going to be Matt landing in Carrion away from the group. I believe it's Carrion. So yeah, I wonder if we go up all the way until then. So that's kind of where I'm going to set this premise. And obviously the girls get to the White Tower and everything, and they figure out a little bit. So it's going to have to be playing a lot with, you're just, like, a lot of time's going to have to pass for this episode. The next episode is is called The Flame of Tarvalin, which is one of the first chapters named in The Great Hunt, but I think this is going to be a little bit later on. It's just referencing that chapter. As I said with the previous episode, I think that there is going to be a lot more focus on Matt, Rand, and Huron, and Perrin, and all of them, and I think with this episode, we're going to get a lot more with the White Tower. We're going to get a lot with what happens in the books, obviously, and we'll probably get up to the point where Nynaeve becomes an accepted. I think that this is what it's this episode's going to be. Just because I think the episode is called The Flame of Tarvalin, we'll probably get some stuff with Swan. I think we'll actually, in this episode, get more with Loghain, because Rafe Judkin says he wants to get more with Loghain, so all the stuff where that comes with capturing him and getting him stilled and stuff like that. So I think we're going to follow more events that are only mentioned in the book, but we'll probably get more of Loghain, more of Swan, that we don't have in the book. So yeah, like I said, gonna have to be moving fast. So I think by the end of this episode, we'll have Nynaeve accepted, and we'll figure out kind of like all that goes into, you know, the beginnings of the White Tower and stuff. Now here in episode 7, it's not titled yet. Episode 7 and 8 don't have titles, but we can only really speculate more from here. From here, we're gonna pick up back with Rand and Carian, and it's gonna be about Rand connecting back with his group and having to head to Falma, where actually where the Shan Chan invasion and then settlement kind of is right now, where they occupy, not a settlement. So the Shan Chan invaded, they have settled in Shan Chan, and we'll probably get some stuff with the White Cloaks who hear about this and are about to go battle them, basically. So we're gonna have Rand and the group heading to Falma, and then probably after that we pick up with Nynaeve, Egwene, Elaine, and Min, and they hear about the boys in trouble, or they will be in trouble in Falma. Obviously they're manipulated by a Black Aja sister, so they're gonna have to be using waygates and stuff to get back to them. And I believe on the end of this episode we will get Egwene collared and the other girls getting away, and then them trying to be like figuring out how to save Egwene. At the same time, I think the last bit of this episode is the ramping up of the climax of like the entire show. All the stuff is going to be in place with the White Cloaks, with the Shan Chan, with Egwene being collared, with Matt getting more and more sick from the dagger because Pot and Fain has it, and then obviously the stuff with the horn. So it's all coming to like a really, you know, big plateau, and I think if it's done right, episode 8 could be one of like the best episodes in all of like TV history. I know that's like a really big like build up, but honestly it's really the culmination of Rand finally becoming the Dragon Reborn. Finally we get episode 8, and I think what happens here is it's going to happen a little bit differently from the books, but I think the stuff with the battle and the stuff happening with Egwene and Rand's group is all going to all sort of like climax near the end. And why I think so is because Egwene gets saved kind of earlier on. I think it's all going to like all like peak together and come together rather than it like being separate climaxes everywhere. But it's just going to be, man, it's going to be like such an epic scene with the White Cloaks fighting the Shan Chan, and then the heroes come at the blow of the horn, and while that's happening we get Egwene getting free and we see Rand in the sky fighting against Balzamon. And dude, it's going to be like, oh dude, it's going to be this crescendo that's going to be so cool to finally like see on television. That's why I think the Eye of the World's like ending is going to be kind of ramped down, because it basically happens twice in Great Hunt and Eye of the World. So I think it's perfect that if done right, we get Eye of the World the first half, and then we get the Great Hunt the second half. And then obviously the very end, we get Rand that sustains his injury that stays with him for the rest of the series. And the end of the show, he finally realizes that, or he's coming to accept the fact that he is the Dragon Reborn and he has to go out and do these things. So, and then I bet we'll have like an epilogue that's going to set up like the next season and all of that. They've already started filming season 2, so that's super exciting. I'm almost 100% positive this is how it's gonna kind of like flow. I didn't really mention New Spring or anything like that, so I'll kind of go over that like briefly. I think that we will have the prologue of Eye of the World in there. I think that'll be I think it's going to be a combination of the Game of Thrones and the Lord of the Rings sort of like setup. I think the first scenes of the series that we'll actually see is the prologue of the Eye of the World. From there, we're going to kind of get a little bit of exposition on what's happening, and then we'll get some scenes with Moraine and the New Spring and stuff like that, and then we'll jump back into Rand and what's going on with them. I'm really just trying to figure out how they're fitting New Spring into it. I first thought it was going to be like flashbacks and stuff like that throughout the first season of like why Moraine is on this journey, or they just like dedicate a whole episode to like a flashback of what's going on. But I think it's just going to be flashbacks like periodically, and not in long, like only like a few minutes, only spanning few minutes, and it's only taking from the key events that are happening there. And I have a whole summary of New Spring if you forgot what it was. It's coming out later this week. But yeah, I don't really know. Like, I don't know how they're gonna fit exposition, prologue, and New Spring before we get into the first events that happen with the Emmonsfield 5. Like, I just don't know how it's going to work. I would love to see you guys' comments and what you think, how that will kind of like flow and work. But like, I don't really know. I think the best way would be giving exposition on kind of the world and status, and then having the prologue of the Eye of the World, and then jumping to the Emmonsfield 5 for a little bit, and then Moraine. And then Moraine maybe talks to Lan throughout the series of like why they're doing this, and we get exposition through New Spring and clips from that. I honestly don't know. Like, I don't know how they're going to fit three books in here. The only way is if they have New Spring as flashbacks, but I just don't know how they're going to fit in those flashbacks. I'm excited to see how they do it, and I hope they do it well. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about that. Make sure while you're down there commenting to like and subscribe. It helps me out a lot. It's going to be a whole week of Wheel of Time this week, and I'm so excited to bring it to you guys. So I'll see you guys in the next one.